and minus I2,
minus K I2, and when K is equal to 1, what is I2 dash? I2 dash is equal to minus of I2. So I am reversing I2 and I am getting I2 dash. And what is I1? I1 is equal to I0 plus I2 dash. So already we have I0, now we have I2 dash, and by parallelogram law of forces, I0 plus I2 dash will give you I1. So now we have got I1, and once we have I1, I can draw I1 R1 in parallel to I1. I1 R1 is parallel to I1 because it is minus E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 J X1. So it is minus E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 J X1 perpendicular to I1 R1, and minus E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 J, I1 J X1 will give you what? Will give you V1. Will give you V1. And I1 R1 plus I1 J X1 is I1 Z1. So closing I1 R1 and I1 J X1, I can draw a line which is I1 Z1. So minus E1 plus I1 Z1 is V1. Minus E1 plus I1 Z1 is also V1. So either we can go like minus E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 J X1 is equal to V1, or minus E1 plus I1 Z1 is equal to V1. So this much part of the phasor diagram is completed. Okay. And when you know V1, the angle between V1 and I1 is called Phi1, which is the primary power factor angle. Okay. And the angle between V1 and I0 is called Phi0, which is the no-load power factor angle cos phi 0. Now we are going to make the phasor diagram of the secondary. Making the phasor diagram of the secondary, what is the equation for secondary? It is E2 minus I2 Z2 is equal to V2. E2 minus I2 Z2 is equal to V2. And what is I2 Z2? I2 Z2 is actually I2 R2 plus I2 JX2. So we have E2 now. We have E2 now. E2 minus E2 minus I2 J X2, E2 minus I2 J X2, because it is in opposite direction. Since it is minus, we are taking it in the opposite direction. Here everything was plus. It was minus E1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 J X1. So it was in the same direction. So here the equation is like, it is E2 minus I1 I2 J X2 minus I2 R2. So we are drawing it in the reverse direction. So it is E2 minus I2 J X2 minus I2 R2 is equal to V2. Is equal to V2. So actually this expression will be more good, because V2 plus I2 R2 plus I2 J X2 is equal to E2. So that means V2 plus I2 R2 plus I2 J X2 is equal to V2. V2 becomes the closing side. So V2 plus I2 R2 plus I2 J X2 is equal to E2. And now you got V2, the angle between I2 and V2 is called Phi2, which is the secondary power factor angle cos Phi2. So the secondary power factor is cos Phi2, the primary power factor is cos Phi1, and the no load power factor is cos Phi0. And I2 R2 plus I2 J X2 can become I2 Z2. So that means you can draw a diagonal vector closing I2 R2 and I2 J X2, which will be I2 Z2. So this is the complete phasor diagram of the practical transformer on load. So I will sum it up. Summing it up, IM plus IW is equal to I0. You draw I2, the reverse of I2 will be I2 dash. I2 dash plus I0 will be I1. And then you know E1 and E2 are equal in magnitude and along the minus y axis. In the primary equation, we need minus E1. So we are reversing E1 and making minus E1. Minus E1 plus I1 R1 parallel to I1 and I1 J X1 perpendicular to I1 R1 will become equal to V1. I1 R1 plus I1 J X1 will be I1 Z1. So the entire primary side will be completed. Angle between V1 and I1 is Phi1, and angle between V1 and I0 is called Phi0, which will contribute to primary power factor angle cos Phi1 and no load power factor angle cos, not angle, no load power factor cos Phi0 and primary power factor cos Phi1. And in the secondary, we are having E2 already. E2 minus I2 J X2 minus I2 R2 will become equal to V2, and I2 R2 plus I2 J X2 is actually I2 Z2, and the angle between V2 and I2 is called phi2, and it becomes the secondary power factor cos phi2. So this is the complete phasor diagram of the practical transformer on load. Now what is our power factor? Our primary power factor is cos phi1 and our secondary power factor is cos phi2. And when you are supplying the power factors cos phi1 and cos phi2, the input power will be V1 I1 cos phi1 and the output power will be V2 I2 cos phi2. Because it is the primary voltage into primary current into primary power factor and the secondary voltage into secondary current into secondary power factor. So this is the primary power P1 and this is the secondary power P2. Now we are going to go into the topic called impedance ratio. This topic is very important because we want to convert our transformer from the secondary to the primary and also from the primary to the secondary. So this is our normal transformer having primary number of turns N1, secondary number of turns N2, primary voltage V1, secondary voltage V2, primary current I1, secondary current I2, and then there is a load. Okay. And what is Z? What is our general equation of Z? Z is V divided by I. Because what is V? V is equal to IZ. Okay, this is Ohm's law. Now, when Z is equal to V divided by I, Z2 is equal to V2 by I2, and Z1 is equal to V1 by I1, isn't it? So, this is the secondary impedance Z2, which is V2 by I2, and this is the primary impedance Z1, which is V1 divided by I1. And I am going to make the ratio Z2 by Z1. And when I am going to substitute the right hand side V2 by V1 into I1 divided by I2, this is going to become, what is V2 divided by V1? V2 divided by V1 is K and I1 by I2 is also K. So Z2 by Z1 become equal to K square, or what is Z2? Z2 becomes equal to K square Z1. Z2 becomes equal to K square Z1. So if you are primary impedance is Z1, the secondary reflection of your primary impedance is K square primary impedance. So that means if you have your primary impedance Z1 and if you want to convert this primary impedance into a secondary impedance, you have to multiply your primary impedance with the turns ratio square. So this transformation factor is one of very important questions normally asked in most competitive examinations, including GATE and the PSU examinations and other PSU examinations as well. Okay, so we will go into transformation of impedance, transformation of voltage, transformation of current. Now, if Z2 divided by Z1 is equal to K square, what are the components of Z? What is Z? Z is equal to R plus JX, isn't it? So the components of Z are R and X. So when R and X are the components of Z, you can also convert this equation in terms of R and X. So when Z2 by Z1 is equal to K square, R2 by R1 is also equal to K square and X2 by X1 is also equal to K square. So this is very, very important because you know there is an R1 in the primary, X1 in the primary, R2 in the secondary and X2 in the secondary. So we will have to convert these into reversibly into primary and into the secondary. Now, I don't want you to remember all these things because when you remember all these things, you will be confusing. Okay, so I want you to remember the conversion from secondary to primary. You just remember conversion from secondary to primary, and once you are clear secondary to primary, then the opposite we can take it from the primary to the secondary. The problem is that if there is a confusing kind of theory that is to be studied, if you study both these theories at the same potential, what will happen is that normally you will confuse between this and automatically you will go with the wrong answer. So if there is two equal type of theory things, then you will have to study only one theory and you have to remember that the other is just the reverse. Study one part and make and remember a relationship with respect to the other part. So that means we will be crystal clear with the part that we remember and there will not be any confusion with respect to the second part once you are clear with the first part. So we are going to remember the transformations from the secondary to the primary. We are not going to remember the transformation from primary to secondary because whatever we remember from secondary to primary, we will take the reverse and we will convert it from primary to secondary. So I want you to remember the conversion from secondary to primary. So a resistance R2 in the secondary becomes R2 by K square when it is transferred to the primary. This is very, very important. And we will just skip this. I will skip point number 1 and point number 3. I have put it in the slide because if you want to study, you just study. But in the mode of teaching, I will just guide you through the conversion from secondary to primary only. Okay. So in the fourth point, a reactance X2 in the secondary becomes X2 by K square when it is transferred to primary. Okay. So when it is R2 by K square and R2 by X2 by K square, the other part will be K square R and K square X. Okay. So we are not going to study the other part. We are only going to study R2 by K square and X2 by K square. So when you are converting things from secondary to primary, we will just sum it up in this slide. When transferring resistance or reactance from primary to secondary, multiply it by K square. Don't remember that. Okay. When transferring resistance or reactance from secondary to primary, you divide it by K square. Okay. When transferring voltages or current from one winding to other, only K is used. Okay. So I am going to sum up all the relationship with respect to secondary to primary. So you have to always remember that we are taking elements from secondary and we are going to insert it into the primary. So you have secondary elements and you are converting secondary elements into their equivalent counterparts in primary. So that means if you have Z2 and then the reflection of Z2 on primary will be Z2 dash. It will be Z2 dash and then it will be Z2 divided by K square. Okay. You must remember this table. This is a very, very, very important table because most of the students, 90% of them will confuse this. Okay. And if this is the case, and if you have an R2, taking R2 from the secondary to the primary, it becomes R2 dash and it is R2 divided by K square. So R2 dash is the element that is to be inverted inserted into the primary as a counterpart of R2 in the secondary. So if you have R2 in the secondary, when you convert R2 in the secondary to the primary, we will write it as R2 dash and then R2 dash value will be R2 divided by K square. So similarly, what is X2 dash? X2 dash is actually X2 by K square. Okay. So this is with respect to the impedance part. Okay. If you have an I2 in the secondary, this you already know. The factor in the primary will be I2 dash. So the reflection of I2 in the primary will be I2 dash and it is equal to KI2. KI2 vectorially or when we are drawing it as a phasor diagram, we normally take it as minus KI2 because it is the counteracting effect of the demagnetizing component of current in the secondary I2. So you will take it as minus I2, but when you are going with the magnitude, you just multiply it with K. So if you have a voltage V2, if you have an voltage V2 in the secondary, converting V2 from secondary to primary, it is going to become V2 divided by K. So this is very, very, very important. Very, very important. Okay. So this table is really very important. You have to put it in a bold box. Okay. So taking elements from secondary and inserting it into the primary. This is very, very important because we are going to move into drawing the equivalent circuit of the transformer. So when you are crystal clear with these things, then it will be really easy for you to go into the theory and there is no need for by-hearting anything. Okay. So you have Z2 in the secondary. If you want to convert Z2 into the primary, it becomes Z2 dash, which is Z2 by K square. If you have R2 in the secondary, if you want to convert R2 from secondary to primary, then it becomes R2 dash and it is R2 by K square. If you have X2 in the secondary and you want to convert X2 from secondary to primary, it becomes X2 dash and it is X2 divided by K square. And if you have I2 in the secondary and you want to take I2 from secondary to primary, it becomes I2 dash and it is K times I2. And if there is V2 in the secondary, then you want to convert V2 from secondary to primary, then it becomes V2 dash and it is V2 divided by K. And now what about conversion from primary to secondary? This becomes K square Z1. If you are going to convert elements from secondary, primary to secondary, then your primary elements are Z1, and then your primary element is R1, and then it is X1, and the current is I1, and the voltage is V1. Okay? So if you are taking Z1 to the secondary, it will become Z1 dash. Z1 dash will be K square Z1. Okay? R1 taken to the secondary becomes R1 dash, and it will be K square R1. And if you are taking X1 to the secondary, it becomes K square X1. It is X1 dash in the secondary. And if you take I1 from primary to secondary, it becomes I1 dash, and it is I1 divided by K. And if you take V1 from primary to secondary, it becomes V1 dash, and that is V1 into K. So it is K V1. So whatever we are converting from secondary to primary, you have to do the just inverse when you are converting it from primary to secondary. So I am only remembering one conversion. I suggest you also remember only one unilateral conversion. Bilateral conversion will create confusion. So I want you to remember only conversion of secondary towards primary. Okay. And if you are very clear with the conversion of secondary to primary, then it is very easy to write the equations of the primary to secondary conversion also. Now, this is our equivalent circuit. Here there is voltage V1 in the primary, there is voltage V2 in the secondary, there is induced EMF E1 in the primary, induced EMF E2 in the secondary, there is a current I1 flowing in the primary, there is a current I2 flowing in the secondary. If it is loaded, but I am assuming there is a load and there is a current I2. Okay. Now there is resistance R1 in the primary, R2 in the secondary, X1 in the primary, X2 in the secondary, N1 number of turns for primary, N2 number of turns for secondary, and our K is equal to N2 divided by N1 equals V2 divided by V1 equals E2 divided by V1 equals I1 divided by I2. So this is the diagram. We are going to convert it into equivalent circuit. So here we are going to shift the impedances from secondary to primary and also from the primary to the secondary. So this is the case. If you want to convert primary impedances to the secondary impedances to the primary, okay? So secondary impedances to the primary means in the primary you are having R1 and in the secondary you are having R2, and when you convert R2 towards the primary, it becomes R2 dash. So what is the total resistance of the primary? It is R01, which is R1 plus R2 dash. And what is R2 dash? R2 dash is R2 by K square. Similarly, there is a reactance in the primary called X1, and you are converting your secondary impedance to primary, then it becomes X2 dash. And what is X2 dash? It is X2 divided by K square, and then X1 plus X2 dash becomes equal to the total reactance of the primary called X01. And your total resistance is R01 and the total reactance is X01, then the total impedance will be equal to root of R01 square plus X01 square. So the equivalent impedance of the transformer referred to primary will be root of R01 square plus X01 square. Now this is the diagram. So in this diagram, there is already an R1 in the primary and X1 in the primary. There was an R2 and X2 in the secondary. So I have converted the R2 from the secondary to primary and also from X2 from the secondary to primary. So when I am taking R2 from the secondary and inserting it in the primary, it becomes R2 dash, which is equal to R2 by K square. And X2 is taken from the secondary and inserted in the primary, it becomes X2 dash, which is equal to X2 divided by K square. And N1 number of turns, N2 number of turns, you already know K is equal to N2 divided by N1. So what is the total resistance of the primary? Total resistance of the primary now is R1 plus R2 dash, which is equal to R01. And the total reactance is X1 plus X2 dash. X1 plus X2 dash, which is equal to X01. And R01 and X01 together makes Z01. And what is Z01? It is R01 plus J X01, or the magnitude of Z01 is equal to root of R01 square plus X01. There is no J, X01 square. So that is why it is written as z01 is equal to root of r01 square plus x01 square. z01 is equal to root of r01 square plus jx01 square. Now, if we are referring impedances from primary to secondary, if we are referring impedances from primary to secondary, our primary impedances are r1 and x1. So we have to take r1 to the secondary and x1 to the secondary. So when you are taking r1 to the secondary, it becomes r1 dash, which is equal to k square r1, and then the total impedance will be the actual secondary resistance r2 plus the new referred resistance from primary to secondary r1 dash, which will be equal to r02. And if you are converting x1 from primary to secondary, it becomes x1 dash, which is equal to k square x1, and the x2 plus k square x1 equals x2 plus x1 dash, which is equal to x02. So now the net resistance of the secondary becomes r02, and the net reactance becomes x02, and r02 plus jx02 is z02, okay, and the absolute value of z02 is equal to root of r02 square plus x02 square. So z02 becomes equal to root of r02 square plus x02 square. So this is the figure. Here there was an r1 and there was an x1. I have referred r1 from primary to the secondary, and I have referred x1 from the primary to the secondary. And when I am referring r1 from primary to secondary, it becomes r1 dash, which is equal to k square r1. X1 becomes x1 dash, which is equal to k square x1, and the net resistance in the primary is, in the secondary, is now r2 plus, not j, r2 plus r2 plus r1 dash, r2 plus r1 dash, which is equal to r02, and the net reactance is x2 plus x1 dash. X2 plus x1 dash, which is equal to k square x1, and then it becomes equal to x02. And then what is z02? z02 is equal to r02 plus jx02, and then its absolute value is r02 square plus x02 square, the whole root, which is equal to z02. And this is the net reactance and this is the net resistance. K is equal to n2 divided by n1, and n1 is the number of turns of the primary and n2 is the number of turns of the secondary. So this is the condition of the equivalent circuit referred to secondary. Now this is, we are going to convert it into exact equivalent circuit. This is the exact equivalent circuit of a transformer, in which you are having the input voltage as V1, your primary induced EMF is E1, secondary induced EMF is E2, and your terminal voltage is V2 across the load ZL. These are things that we already know. We know all these things, okay? And N1 is the number of turns of the primary and N2 is the number of turns of the secondary. In the secondary, we are having an R2 and X2, and a current I2 is circulating in the secondary. So secondary part is finished. In the primary part, we are having a current I1, which is equal to I0 plus I2 dash. And you know what is I0 plus I2 dash, okay? So by Kirchhoff's current law, this current is passing through R1 and X1. And then this current I0 plus I2 dash is coming to this junction, okay? What is the total current? Our total current is I1. And I1 is equal to I0 plus I2 dash. And I0 plus I2 dash is passing through this line consisting of R1 and X1. And it comes to the junction. And at this junction, the current divides into two. It divides into I0 and I2 dash, because by Kirchhoff's current law, I0 plus I2 dash is equal to I1. So the net incoming current is equal to algebraic sum of outgoing currents. Algebraic sum of outgoing currents means I0 plus I2 dash becomes equal to I1. And here I0 and I2 dash splits into two. I0 is the no load component of current. Okay. This no load component of current, what is the components of I0? The components of I0 are Im and Iw. So vector Im plus vector Iw is equal to vector I0. So I0 again splits into two currents, Im and Iw, where Iw is the working component of current passing through resistance R0, and Im is the magnetizing component of the current passing through the reactance X0. Because the magnetizing component of current passes through the inductance, because it is the winding representation which is to be magnetized. Now, the working component or the active component of power is consumed only by the resistor. So, the IW current passes through the resistance R0. So, I0 is actually part of I1. So, I1 is equal to I2 dash plus I0. So, in the first junction, I0 and I2 dash splits into two. And at the second junction, I0 itself splits into two as IM and IW. IM is the magnetizing component passing through the inductor and IW is the working component passing through the resistor. And so this is I0 is equal to IM plus IW. IM passes through X0, IW passes through R0, and then I2 dash is passing into the winding, primary winding having N1 number of turns, and you know I2 dash is equal to K times I2. So this is the exact equivalent circuit of a transformer, and now you know each and every component that is coming into this figure. And if you are simplifying this, you can take the no load part of the shunt part of the equivalent circuit. This part of the equivalent circuit is called the shunt part of the equivalent circuit, and this part including R1 X1 and R2 X2 are called the series part of the equivalent circuit. So now for simplifying this equivalent circuit, I have taken the shunt part into the starting. So I have taken the shunt part before R1 and X1. You can see that in this figure, the shunt part is after R1 and X1. So I am taking it before R1 and X1. So this is before R1 and X1. And what is our I1? I1 is equal to I0 plus I2 dash. So here the junction is inserted first, such that I1 splits into two initially itself. So I1 splits into I0, and this component will be I2 dash. This component of current is I2 dash. So I0 plus I2 dash is equal to I1. I0 splits into IW and IM. IM passes through X0, IW passes through R0. V1 is our input voltage. E1 and E2 are the secondary primary induced EMFs. V2 is the terminal voltage across load ZL. N1 and N2 are the windings with the primary and the secondary. There is R1 and X1 in the primary, R2 and X2 in the secondary. There is I2 current in the secondary, and there is the reflection current I2 dash is equal to K times I2 in the primary. So this is the simplified format. How the simplification comes is that here through R1 and X1 only I2 dash is flowing, and I0 is initially flowing into the shunt path. But here through R1 and X1, the total current I0 plus I2 dash is flowing. So it becomes a little bit tedious, because mathematical solution of R1 and X1 with respect to the total current of I2 dash plus I0 is little bit complex compared to passing only I2 dash through R1 and X1. So here R1 and X1 carries only current I2 dash. I0 initially itself splits into IM and IW and passes through the shunt path. So this is a simplified equivalent circuit of the practical transformer, which is loaded with an impedance ZL at the secondary. Now we are eliminating the winding in between. This is an ideal transformer representation, which includes two windings of the primary and the secondary having N1 and N2. So even though we have drawn the equivalent circuit, this primary part and the secondary part is actually electrically isolated. So what we are going to do is that we are going to refer the terms in the secondary towards the primary, and we are going to eliminate this winding part. Okay, so I am eliminating the winding part which was in between. So E1 becomes equal to E2. So here there was the winding, and the winding is eliminated. And I am referring all parameters in the secondary towards the primary. So what happens when I am referring secondary parameters to primary? Impedance becomes divided by K square. R2 dash is actually R2 by K square. X2 dash is actually X2 divided by K square. Current becomes K times, and voltage becomes divided by K. So once you study these things systematically, clearly, this is really easy. There is no very much difference compared to the previous diagram and the new diagram. And all these things that is written, even though it looks tedious, it's so simple because we already know what is these things. Because K2 dash, it is not K2 dash, it is R2 dash. R2 dash is R2 divided by K square, we already know, because Z is Z by K square. So R is R2 by K square, and X is X2 by K square. I is equal to K times I2, and V is equal to V by K. Okay.